Hey everyone, my name is Paxton and I'm a math content specialist here at UWorld. And today I'm going to go over a little strategy about how to approach certain system of equations questions. So the question gives a system of equations. 2x plus 7y equals 44 and x plus 6y equals 37. Now also notice that it asks you for the value of x plus y. You might think, oh, I can solve this using either the elimination or substitution methods. And while those are both ways to solve it, they may take a little bit more time than you really want to spend on this question. So I'm going to show you a strategy about how to approach these types of questions. So when a question asks you for the value of a desired expression, such as x plus y, rather than values of specific variables, like x or y, it is often possible to add or subtract the given equations and solve for the desired expression. So I'm going to show you that with our question here. All right, so first thing you want to do is check if adding or subtracting the equations results in the desired expression. So let's do that. We have 2x plus 7y equals 44, and we have x plus 6y equals 37. So let's first add it just to check. All right. So if we add these two equations together, we have 2x plus x, which is 3x, 7y plus 6y, which is 13y. So then we have 13y. And then we have 44 plus 37, which is 81. So adding these two equations in the given system of equations results in 3x plus 13y equals 81. Now, that's not the desired expression, x plus y. So let's check what happens if we subtract them. So 2x plus 7y equals 44, and x plus 6y equals 37. Again, we're going to check if what happens with when we subtract them. All right, so 2x minus x results in x. Then 7y minus 6y results in a positive y. And 44 minus 37 results in 7. So subtracting the two given equations results in x plus y equals 7. And look at that. Your desired expression, x plus y. And we also see that x plus y equals 7. So our answer is 7. So you found the value of x plus y without using the multiple steps of the elimination or substitution methods. Now, of course, this won't always be the case. And so you may have to use one of these methods to solve for a specific variable, or you might get a multiple of the desired expression and have to do a few more steps to solve for the right answer. But with practice, you'll be able to know when to apply this strategy in no time. So make sure you check out UWorld to see detailed explanations about this strategy, about the elimination and substitution methods, and about everything else you might see on the test. I hope this has been helpful. And if it has, make sure to like, share, and subscribe to our channel and check out other videos like this one. And remember, your dream school requires a dream score. So keep prepping and studying with UWorld and you'll do great.